lay face down is pneumonia. Not sure what you're talking about there. I think you may be meaning that once you get into acute respiratory distress syndrome, they have found a few things that greatly improve your survival in the ICU. MedCram, they've got some really good stuff for those of you that want to get technical. A couple of months ago, MedCram covered some of the recent developments in terms of managing sepsis and specifically ARDS, having people on the respirator in ICU. And I think he specifically did go into some mention about COVID-19. So what happens with COVID-19 in your lungs is it your lungs get inflamed. The air sacs or alveoli, the space around those air sacs becomes flooded. So that extra water sort of pushes them in. What we find that we have to do in the ICU is blow those sacs open. That helps immensely. That takes a mortality rate from 42% down to about the mid-30s. But the problem with it happens next is that use pressure to blow that alveoli completely back up. You cause more inflammation. They do minimal level. Now, in order to do that minimal level, your brain doesn't trust that. So your brain is fighting the ventilator. So they have to paralyze you. And as Billy the Weasel said a second ago, I think this is what Billy was talking about. They have also found that flipping you over on your stomach for this is a significant improvement in mortality. So you do those three things, flipping them over on their stomach, doing the lower ventilation levels, the lower tidal volume levels, paralyzing you. Those three things take a mortality rate in the 40s down to the mid-teens. So significant improvement there. Continue to get great feedback regarding the webinars. And here's why. You know, on the internet, when you hear a webinar, you expect for somebody to try to sell you something. We're not doing that. We're trying to tell you something. People are coming in with their labs from Quest, inflammation panel, OGTT, insulin survey response, and then they're finding out, do I have inflammation? Do I have insulin resistance? And where does that fit in terms of other folks? We're getting ready to start one for CIMT as well. So again, people are really excited about finding out their own status. Looking forward to seeing you there. Thanks.